Hello, I'm Khemasuri and I'm speaking to you this morning from the very beautiful Sheffield Buddhist Centre. And this morning I'm going to give a talk about how to become a trainee Bodhisattva. A Bodhisattva is any being whose whole life is dedicated to the attainment of enlightenment, not just for themselves, but for all beings. This is a really big vision, and this vision is established through compassion, how we act, and the motivation behind our actions. I like to think that anyone seriously practicing the Dharma, the teachings of the Buddha, is in fact a trainee Bodhisattva. When we follow the teachings of the Buddha, we are all learning how to act for the benefit of all beings. Although it's a very high ideal, it can become the driving force behind our day-to-day decisions and actions. When the Buddha became enlightened, he realized the truth of interconnection, not as a theory, but as a direct experience, a realization of what was called in the Buddha's time, the way things are. This truth of interconnection, the Buddha called pratitya samutpada, and is also known as the law of conditionality. The law of conditionality is a universal and natural law, like the law of gravity. It means that our thoughts, speech, and actions will always have an effect on the world around us. We cannot but have an effect. Our actions will always have consequences, both for ourselves, others, and the world we live in. This is very good. This means we can make a difference to the world around us, and it is a world that seriously needs our love, compassion, awareness, and ethical sensibility. In 1971, the founder of Tri Ratna Sangharakshita gave a talk called Evolution or Extinction, a Buddhist View of Current World Problems. And this book talk can be found in the back of the book, What is the Sangha, if you're interested. In this talk, he talks about the problems the world faces, economic, political, commercial, social, racial, and I would now add, 45 years later, ecological, population pressures, movements of people, and perhaps most pressing, climate change. This world is in deep trouble. Sangharakshita speaks about promoting change. He talks about spiritual development and the spiritual community as essential foundations for change. He says that we can have strong reactions to the cruelties and injustices of our world. But when this initial reaction has exhausted itself, we can feel drained and powerless. The problems of the world can seem far too big for us to do anything about. So we try to forget them. We close down and our lives can become small and limited. As Sangharakshita says in the talk, we are sorry that others suffer, but at least we can enjoy our own lives. But he does not stop there and he says very clearly, however, my view is that such an attitude of withdrawal from public concerns into purely personal ones is one that is not worthy of a human being. It represents an abdication of responsibility. Here is where the trainee Bodhisattva remembers the law of conditionality. They remember that all our actions have consequences and we can always be agents for positive change. With the power of ethical action behind us, we can make a difference. It's a heroic ideal, and we can train ourselves to respond to the difficulties of the world, to become more of a Bodhisattva. Sangharakshita tells us that the first thing we must do is self-develop. We can raise our awareness of ourselves and others through meditation, which helps us see more clearly how we can act ethically in the world. The trainee Bodhisattva is strong enough to look at suffering in the face and not to turn away, strong enough to see what needs to be done and to follow it through. Sagarashta says, self-development always comes first. However active you might be in all sorts of external areas, political, social, educational, or whatever. If you are not making an effort to develop yourself, you are not going to be able to make a truly positive contribution to anything or anyone. He next talks about joining or creating a spiritual community. We promote change with others because when we come together, we are stronger than we are on our own. We do not have to do this on our own. One of the most important aspects of the spiritual community for me is that it is an ideal position to critique the society we live in, an ideal position to challenge cultural assumptions and habitual ways of living. The spiritual community values kindness, doing no harm, and being easy to support. Sangharakshita says, the fact that we have the financial resources to help ourselves to whatever we fancy does not justify our consuming the wealth of the world without consideration for the claims of others, both in the present and in the future, to those same resources. He then starts to talk about other ways to influence the future of the world. He suggests we withdraw support from all anti-spiritual forces and exert an influence for good in any group unavoidably we belong to. This is having as little as possible to do with groups and organisations that promote greed, hatred, and delusion. He says, it is always possible to act in accordance with one's ideals. There is no need to surrender your individuality. Encourage people to think for themselves and to develop their own minds. I would also like to add that we can join with other communities to promote spiritual values. For example, peace groups, anti-globalisation networks, organisations that protect the environment and promote social justice. There are many good outfits working towards the health and well-being of the world and its inhabitants. But take your Buddhist values and principles with you. Do not leave them at home. Remember, you have something very valuable to offer the world. Sangharakshita concludes the talk with saying, it doesn't matter how humble a level we are operating at or how undramatic our work may be. If enough earthworms burrow under the foundations of even the most substantial building, the soil begins to loosen. It starts to crumble away. The foundations subside and the whole building is liable to crack and collapse. Likewise, however powerful the existing order may seem, it is not invulnerable to the undermining effect of enough influence working, whether directly or indirectly, in cooperation. The trainee Bodhisattva is a radical being. It is radical to know who we are and to be able to stand our ground and speak our minds. It is radical to challenge the culture we live in without turning away or resorting to hatred and blame. The spiritual community of trainee Bodhisattvas is a radical community. It is based on the ethics of compassion and wisdom. It is a community which comes together based on the values of friendship, simplicity, and non-craving. We have to remember and honour the fact that we have a distinctive and relevant alternative way of looking at the world. The spiritual community has the ability to challenge cultural assumptions through spreading the Dharma. This may not make us popular. Here is Sangharakshita again. It is easy to forget that the Buddhist message is a subversive one, that its values run counter to the mundane or worldly norms, and that your commitment to its ethical principles may lead you to, on occasion, offend conventional notions of morality. So we might as well act with integrity, decisiveness, and as much kindness, generosity, and clarity as we can manage. The law of conditionality means that ethical actions will have positive consequences, although we may never know what they are. We might as well act according to our ideals and principles, be prepared to be subversive, speak out, take risks, and trust the process. And remember that we do not have to do this on our own. By acting in this way, we give cosmic significance to our day-to-day experience. As trainee bodhisattvas, we are no longer powerless, and we can live passionately, courageously, and in joy.